How'd you get on, Peterson?
The whole thing was a complete farce. Disgrace.
Mrs. Morris.
I'm sorry.
That's all I need to end an otherwise perfect day. Good dose of pity from my friendly jailer.
It's not pity. You had a fair trial. Dinner's almost over, but I can get you something if you like.
I know you mean well, Mrs. Morris, but no thank you. Unless, of course, some real food has found its way in here at last.
Catherine Elaine Peterson. You have been charged and convicted of obtaining money by fraud, falsifying Medibank returns, conspiring to import prohibited drugs into Her Majesty's Prison, Wentworth.
She's here. All right, girls, you know what to do. What are you doing back here? I thought the judge was going to give you a full pardon.
No, not this time. They were all amateurs. The judge was a pompous fool, and my so-called defense counsel was moronic.
Ah, that's bad luck. Still, hasn't been a total loss, has it?
What do you mean?
Well, today must be your lucky day.
I'm sure there's a point to all this. Would you mind coming to it?
Fair enough. I take it you weren't too happy with your trial.
Brilliant observation. You really are getting better.
Ta. Well, the girls are going to give you a trial you'll be crazy about. Now, you weren't very happy with your defense counsel. Well, they are hard to come by. But we've got you the best. Judy. Meet your new client, Dr. Catherine Peterson. We couldn't find anyone to be prosecuting counsel, so I volunteered. She'll be a pushover.
God, you women are childish. I'm not interested in playing your stupid games.
Oh, you will be, Kate. You don't even know what the game is yet. You haven't even met the judge. Rita. Meet Justice Sandy Edwards. Unfortunately, Sandy couldn't be here in person. But then you'd know all about that, wouldn't you?
Go on. You haven't told me what this farce is all about yet.
Oh, yes, I have. We're going to give you a fair trial on all the charges the cops missed. Now, the girls here are going to be the jury. They know what it's like to be in prison. They'll be very sympathetic.
What about Winter?
Oh, yeah. I'd forgotten about her. You see, there are a few laws that we haven't caught up with yet. Now, if you're innocent, oh, you'll be as free as a bird. But we haven't abolished the death penalty. So if you're found guilty, you're dead. And that's where Mari comes in. She's our public executioner. Mari, meet your next customer, Dr. Catherine Peterson.
You just sit here and you keep quiet unless you're asked a question. I'll do the talking.
I've got nothing to say to this rabble.
Oh, you better think of something, mate, because they're serious.
All right, you've had enough time to prepare your defense. Let's get this show on the road. Lil, you're the clerk of courts. Read the charge. Lil?
This is ridiculous.
Shut up.
Yeah?
Where the hell have you been?
I was just checking. There was no screws about.
Well, Joy can give Margot a hand. You get your body over here and read the charges.
Catherine Peterson, you're charged with lagging to the cops, lagging to the screws, spoiling the kitchen swindle, and getting your mates longer prison sentences. How do you plead?
I haven't got any mates in here. Mm-hmm. Not anymore, you haven't.
All right, Mum.
My client pleads not guilty. And I would also like to point out that although these unproven charges are serious, they don't warrant the death penalty.
Well, there's one charge you haven't heard yet.
What do you mean?
You'll find out what it is later.
Oh, come on, B. You can't try someone unless she knows what the charges are.
We can do whatever we like.
And if you don't like it, you can complain to the judge.
But the judge is a dummy.
All judges are dummies.
Yeah, well, it's obvious that everyone here feels they've been dobbed in by Kate. Now, how can we have a fair trial? You're all biased.
If you break society's rules, society takes you away and locks you up. If you break our rules, we try you.
Now, we can't lock you up. So we have to find a more permanent method of keeping you out of trouble. Is it all clear?
Yeah.
All right, let's get going before we're disturbed.
Yeah.
When Mr. Fletcher left here, we all thought things were going to get better. Mrs. Morris was the most senior officer, so she got the job. But they took it away from her and gave it to Powell. And how come? Because Powell was onto every lurk in the place. She found the letter that Sandy was blackmailing her with, and she caught me red-handed with the stuff I stole from the kitchen. And I got an extra 6 months for that. Now, there's only one way she could have managed it. She has to have had a pet lager, and we all know who that was.
There's no proof.
This is just the prosecutor's opening address. The proof comes later. Now, I thought you would have been in court often enough to know that, Jude.
Well, we all haven't had your experience be.
There's a screw coming.
See if you can cut her off. Quick, girls, having a play reading. Get your books out.
Pearl!
I thought you were supposed to be defending me.
I am.
Pearl's gone. So's Joy and Margot.
Keep an eye out for them. Right. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. Peterson's lagging. The last time was against young Susie Driscoll, a young kid who'd never done anyone any harm. When she tried to escape by pretending her arm was broken, you dobbed her in.
Powell knew she was faking.
Because you told her.
She guessed.
You bloody liar!
There's still no proof.
Proof? Oh, you want proof? All right, I'll give you proof. Come here, Mari. Now, you all know what Queen's evidence is, don't you? It's when some rotten bludger who was in on the crime turns around and lags on their mates, so they won't cop any of the punishment. Well, Mari here is going to turn Queen's evidence. But we're not going to touch her, because she's going to lag on Kate. Go on, Mari. Tell him what a rotten bastard you've been.
It wasn't me, it was her. She turned on her own mate.
Which mate?
Edwards.
How?
When I first took over the drug racket, we found a letter from Fitzwater in the laundry bag. He wanted a favour from Edwards. Only she never got that letter. Peterson wrote a reply and sent it off. But it wasn't what Fitzwater wanted to hear. So he had Edwards' husband killed.
You wrote the letter.
You told me what to say, and it wasn't the only time you did the dirty on her either.
What else did she do?
When I wanted to kill Edwards, Peterson set her up. She gave us something to make her real sick so she'd have to go to the shower block where we was waiting for her.
And that was one of her own mates she set up.
Yeah.
It's all lies.
Now, just a second. You can't call this evidence. Everyone knows that Mari hated Sandy. She'd do anything to get at her.
Well, what better evidence could you have than from someone who was actually involved?
Yeah, well, there was something else I wasn't involved in. Edwards had a knife. And now Peterson's got it. She took it off her just before she killed her. She put her in the garbage truck and had her crushed to death, she told me.
That's not true. I didn't tell you anything.
No, but you did it, didn't you?
There you are, Jude. Do you think that warrants a death penalty? Two people are dead because of that bitch.
It's not true. How did you know that Kate got Sandy's knife?
Because I saw it. I'm surprised you haven't seen it either. You share a room with her. She keeps it hidden in a pillow. If I was you, I'd sleep with one eye open.
What made you so sure that it was Sandy's?
I gave it to her.
Gave it to her? Or did she take it from you?
What difference does it make? It was mine, Edwards had it, now Peterson's got it.
Well, that doesn't prove that she killed her.
Well, I can't see Edwards giving it to her, not in that way anyway. That wasn't quite what she had in mind.
Well, what did she have in mind?
What do you reckon?
I'm asking you.
Oh, come on, Jude. You're carrying on like Perry Mason.
I'm entitled to ask questions.
What for?
So that Kate can have a fair trial.
Oh, yeah, she deserves a fair trial. Then we'll kill her, bitch.
Well, you can hardly call this fair when they've already made up their minds.
Of course they have. We all know she's guilty.
Not until we've heard all the evidence.
Why are you taking this so seriously?
It is serious. My God, we're talking about someone's life here. If it was one of you, you'd want a fair trial, wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? Isn't that what you'd want, Lil?
Suppose so.
Wouldn't make any difference, Lil. You'd still be guilty anyway.
I'm not guilty. I've lost 6 months of my parole, and I'm in here for something I didn't even do.
But your trial comes up in a couple of days. You will probably get off.
I'll only get off if I get a fair trial. Now, I want that for me, and I want a fair trial for Kate.
Oh, and go on. Go ahead. Have your fair trial. It won't make any bloody difference anyway. They all find she's guilty.
Right. Now, what was Sandy going to do with that knife?
She was going to kill that bitch.
So if Kate killed her...
I didn't.
I said if. If Kate killed her, that would have been in self-defense. I mean, you can't blame anyone for defending themselves, can you?